satellite going around, and it says the distance above the surface. It doesn't say the orbital radius. It says the distance above the surface is 3 times the radius of Mars. Well, that means the actual orbital radius is 4 times the radius of Mars, because the distance between here and here is r. And so the distance between the center and there is 4 times r. So as compared to the acceleration of gravity on the surface of Mars, well, it's not the same, right? It's on the surface, you're at a distance of r away. Out here, you're a distance of 4r away. And since the gravitational force is based on the square of the distance, we would now put a 4 in here. 4 squared is 16. So you'd be 1/16 as much if you're 4 times further away. All right, so we've got 2 moons for number 10, orbiting a planet in nearly circular orbits. Moon A has an orbital radius r, and Moon B has an orbital radius 4r. Moon A takes 20 days to complete one orbit. Okay, so here's where Kepler's third law comes in handy. So we know that T squared equals 4 pi squared over g times the mass of this central body times r cubed. Okay, we derived that, and you might have to, if this is not on your formula sheet, you can derive it as we've done by saying that the net force is a centripetal force and the net force is gravitational. This can lead you right to this by using b equals 2 pi r over t. However, here's a little secret. If you just do the ratio, ooh, that guy's weird up close. If you just do the ratio of the period squared to the radius cubed, it's going to be constant for everything, everything orbiting the same body. So in other words, if I divide this by r cubed, that goes away right here. Notice this is constant. And so for everything orbiting, for all the satellites of the same central body, this ratio of t squared over r cubed is going to be identical. So I could say t squared of moon A over r cubed, r cubed of moon A. It equals that. And guess what? The period of b squared over the orbital radius of b cubed is also equal to that. If a equals b and b equals c, then a equals c. Right, that's a little math fact, right? All right, so we've got, where are we? This is number 10, yeah. We've got a period of 20 days for moon A. So I'm gonna substitute that in here, 20 days. And a orbital radius of A of just r, so I'm going to call that r cubed. And here we're looking for the period of B. We square that. And the orbital radius of B is, 4 times bigger? Yeah, it's 4r. So 4r, and we'll cube that. Okay. Now that looks complicated, Mr. Kirov. I'm a little scared. Okay, don't be so scared, it's not so bad. 20 squared is 400. So we've got 400 days squared over r cubed. On the right, and on the left, we've got tb squared over, 4 cubed is what, 64?
Yeah, Mr. Kuda.
Yep, okay. Check this out. The r cubes cancel out on both sides. Okay, now I'm going to multiply 64 by 400, and that's what t squared will equal. So tb squared equals 0, 0, 16. Equals that many days squared. And so I'm going to take the square root of that to find the actual period of, well, you do that. I don't have a calculator handy. So the square root of that will be your number of days, okay? But a couple things I can do to just eliminate wrong answers right away and give myself a fighting chance, even if you're like, Kuda, I'm not ever going to be able to do this, right? First off, we know that we're further away, right? And the further away we get from that central body, the longer the period. So we can get rid of answer A right away because moon A was 20 days. But we also know that it's not a direct relationship. So that if you're four times away, you're not going to be four times as long, right? So it wouldn't be 80 days either. So now you got a fighting chance here because now you're dealing with either C or D. And my money's on C. Okay, number 11. We go for a spacewalk at a distance above Earth's surface equal to the radius of Earth. What is the acceleration due to gravity? Well, on the surface of the Earth, you are one Earth's radius away. Now we're a distance, another Earth's radius away. So now we're twice as far away from the center of the Earth. If we're twice as far away from the center of the Earth, we are going to be 1/4 as heavy, and also that means our gravitational field strength will be 1/4 as much. Again, we're going back to force of gravity equal g, m1, m2 over r squared. This video is 22 minutes long already. This is crazy. Okay, let's move on. We've got the radius of Earth is r. At what distance above Earth's surface will the acceleration of gravity be 4.9 meters per second squared? Okay, well, so that means our acceleration due to gravity is half as much, or where would we weigh, or where would the force of gravity even be half as much? Well, let's see. So, force of gravity equals gm1, mass of the Earth, divided by r squared. Right? And remember, force of gravity is just the mass times little g at that particular location in space. All right, so my mass is kind of irrelevant for the acceleration due to gravity or the gravitational field strength at that point. So I want to know where my g, where little g is half as much as it normally is. Well, that means r squared would have to equal 2. Okay? Would equal twice the normal radius of the Earth. And if you take the square root of that, you're going to get 1.41, or the square root of 2 times the radius of the Earth. Okay. But again, here's one of those things where you can apply some reasoning to make your life a little easier. What distance above, you know what? I didn't even read close enough. What distance above Earth's surface? That's my answer, okay, and here's why. Earth's surface is one Earth radius away, right? And that's not what they're asking me for. They're asking me for how far above that point would I be when G is half as much as it normally is, or half as much as it is on the surface. Okay. A couple things you can do there. We can eliminate this right away because at twice the distance, we would have 1/4 of the normal. Okay, and that also eliminates this because the further we go out, we'd be even smaller. Bye, everybody. So now we're down to a 50-50 chance, okay? But we know we're dealing with a square root issue, so how to put this. So anyway, this is how you eliminate these two wrong answers. We want G to be half as much as it normally is. you know, big G is going to be the same. The mass of the Earth isn't going to change. The only thing that can change is the radius here. And if we want this to be G over 2 instead, then this has to be like that. And if we take the square root, we've got the square root of 2r. Oops. Square root of 2r would be 1.41r. But that's how far we should be from the actual center. And if this is 1r and this whole distance is 1.41r, then the difference is 0.41r. Okay. So like I said, I haven't thought these through ahead of time, so you're kind of seeing my wheels turning at the same time. So that's why the explanation seemed to be a little more convoluted than normal. For the next one, this is how much it weighs one Earth radius away from the center of the Earth, which would be at the surface, and of height of 3r above Earth's surface. So your actual distance is not 3 times greater, it's 4 times greater. Again, if this is the Earth, that's the Earth's radius. And they said there's 3 Earth radiuses above the Earth. Okay, so the actual distance is 4 Earth radii away, which is 4 times bigger than it would be at the surface. If you're 4 times further away, you are 4 squared times less force, or you have 4 squared times less gravitational force. So I would divide 432 by 16, and that's going to give me probably 27. Couple answers, obviously, you can get rid of, right? Your force is never going to be zero unless you're at an infinite distance away. Your force is not going to be the same if your distance has changed, but your mass hasn't. And so you'd, again, be down to a 50-50 chance. The weight of a satellite on a planet's surface is W, which is closest to the weight of the satellite when it's in orbit. Well, this is a pretty poor question. I'm thinking they're going for C, just for this reason. We tend to think of satellite orbits as being like super far away. In reality, like if this is the Earth and this is the Moon out here, and the Moon is orbiting way out here, an actual satellite that we put into space is like right there. It's super close to the Earth's surface relative to its radius. And so you would actually have almost all your same weight. Like the space station astronauts have about 90% of their weight on Earth. They just don't have any normal force. So they're constantly falling towards the Earth, but not getting any closer. Because they have enough tangential speed. They're basically projectiles of just circling the Earth. All right, so we've got two satellites. One has twice the mass of the other, and they orbit the same planet, where the mass of the planet is significantly bigger than the mass of the satellite. And they're at the same height. If you recall, we boiled down, well, you know what, I'll just do it right now, because this is our launching point. The net force is the centripetal force, because it's moving in a circle. The net force is the force of gravity, because it's the only force acting on a satellite. And so that's the centripetal force. So G times the mass of the satellite times the mass of the planet, divided by the orbital radius squared equals M, the mass of the satellite, times the speed of the satellite divided by the orbital radius of the satellite. The speed is squared. So that cancels out the mass of the satellite. Look, the mass of the satellite makes no difference. The only thing that makes a difference to the speed is the mass of the planet and the orbital radius. Now it's the same planet, so that didn't change for either one of them. The orbital radius, they're saying that they're orbiting at the same height above the surface, so their orbital radii will also be the same. And so if the mass of the planet and the orbital rays and G are